Vijay Danvi and you guys are watching City Trends only on Hathway BTV Yuva. Kyunki ye zamana hai we the youngsters ka. Well, keep on saying that ye zamana hai we the youngsters ka because youngsters keep on proving us on the grounds of innovative, in our grounds of creativity and everything. And Indore ek specifically is aisi jagah jisko sirf khane ke naam se jana jata hai, but yahan ke youngsters are top of everything and they have been proving ki Indore sirf khane ke liye famous nahi hai but unke talent ke liye bhi famous hai. So well, today we have with us Mannat Singh, jinki jitni bhi tarif ki jaye yahan pe kam hai because at such a tender age she has done enormous job in the field of fashion modeling and now she has semi-finalist in Femina Miss India. Hello Mannat, welcome to our show. First of all, a big congratulations on your huge success. And starting with your journey, like you have been to so many platforms before and you know kisi ki bhi journey easy nahi hoti. Hum log youngsters kya karte hai, pehle struggle story taiyar karke rakhte hai, uske baad we get on success. But eventually you got your success at such tender age, so how was your journey?
Well, my journey started last year, exactly last year, and at Mr. and Miss Indore auditions, and I was just a normal girl who just walked in, and my mom pushed me that, Mannat, you have a great height, why not go for it? And I had no clue, I had no interest in getting into modeling. So I just went there and they welcomed me and they really liked my height and they saw some potential in me which I don't think I ever saw in myself. And then we had this training procedure for 15 days and it went on, and after the training I was altogether a different person. And then they pushed us to go for Miss Diva, and then I started preparing myself. I thought that, you know, why not give it a try? If people think, if they see something in me, there must be something in me. So why not explore things? So I went for it and then I lost weight for that, but I couldn't get selected at that time. I came to top 24. Then I had the opportunity to take part in Campus Princess, which is also an organization by Miss India. And after that, they started the training and everything. And then they pushed me to go for the Miss India. And I definitely knew that this time I want to get in and I want to bring the crown. So I was planning to come from Indore and MP and represent my state. But I received a call from them and they said that, Mannat, your father is born in Kerala. We are supposed, we can participate from our father's birthplace and our mother's birthplace. So they told me that, why not go from Kerala? I said, but I've never been there. How will the people of Kerala accept me as Miss Kerala? Yes. How will they do that? So they said that, Mannat, just go there and give it a try. You know, you don't know, you don't want to miss any opportunity. And I was in Bombay at that time. I was doing a few shows there. So I was there for a month. And every show, every pageant that I go to, my parents accompany me. But that time they called me a day before. The audition was on 25th Feb and they called me at 24th in the evening that you have to fly down tomorrow 10 o'clock in Kochi. And that is a long distance to travel. From, even from Mumbai to Kochi. Hectic. But then they said, why miss any opportunity? You know, you may find something new. And if not, go from Madhya Pradesh. So I still had that, you know, no, I'll represent my state only. I want to go from my state. And then I just called up my father and I said, Papa, what should I do? I mean, Kochi, and why were you born there? And I just told them. And it was like, it came as a shock that, you know, I just told them that I'm not prepared, I cannot do it. But then I called Papa and he said that, Mannat, he didn't even ask me and he said, go for it. And I was like, you won't tell me ki kya karo, nahi, go for it, don't think, just go for it. And then he said, I'm booking your tickets. And in the next 15 minutes, he booked my tickets, he planned everything. And in Kochi, there's nobody I could go to. So I had my flight at 3 o'clock in the night and I had to travel. I left home at 12 and I didn't sleep that time. All night I didn't sleep and I was all alone. This was the first time I was traveling without my parents to any pageant and to a totally new city. So that was a different experience altogether. So I went there and in the morning I reached quite early and I didn't have any place to go. So I was just roaming around in the mall and meeting people like that only.
Actually, yeah. This journey you're telling is it's full of roller coaster, right? It's no less than a roller coaster. And what if you, even your parents weren't with you? Yeah. They were actually with you.
They definitely were. And I really thought that, you know, there's this communication gap between people in Kerala and me because I cannot speak their language. But that didn't really bother because we had this instant connection. And after that, I went for the pageant. And when they were asking me the question, they asked me that, Mannat, why Kerala? And what is that one thing that you like about Kerala? So what I noticed about Kerala in that 5 hours is that, you know, the simplicity in the lifestyle. Like, people are very simple. They don't want to show off and everything. Very simple homes, very simple clothing. Everything was very simple. So that's what I felt, and I said that. And they said that, did you make friends? I said, I spoke over to 25 people. And 15 to 20 of them didn't even speak English or Hindi. But we were interacting with actions. And we had this instant connection. So they thought that, you know, and then I explained it to them that it's all about making a connection and not being Miss Kerala or Miss Madhya Pradesh or anything. It's just about connecting with people. Because at the end, you're going to go for Miss India. You're going to be Miss India and represent your country altogether.
I can actually see the spark in her eyes while she was saying, nah, I want to become this. And when I interact, when I connect, I can see the spark in your eyes. And it's actually very beautiful that you have confidence in everything. So, Mannat, actually, I loved your name, first of all. I would love to compliment you. I loved your name. So from being a normal girl who never thought of been into something like modeling or ramp walks or something like that, and turned around, your world just turned around upside. Yeah. So kaisa ye jo transformation hai, how are you taking this everything? Because people must come to you and say, "Arey, she's Miss Indore." Like, it is something very different feeling. So how are you taking this transformation and kaisa lagta hai? How does it feel?
Yeah, so from a girl who didn't even care about what she has to wear, now she has to walk in heels half her day. Like 12 hours she has to walk in heels. She has to wear very good clothing. She needs to do her hair. She needs to do her makeup. And yesterday when I was judging the Mr. and Miss Indore panel, so girls were coming up to me and telling me that, Mannat, you are our inspiration. And I am 2 to 3 years younger to them. And they are telling me that. So I think I was very, very touched by that. And it is a very big thing, yeah. At this time of 1 year, and it really, really gave me an overwhelming feeling.
Wow. Actually, ek compliment aisa paana, it's itself a huge success. Yeah. So, what is that one thing you love about now you are in this field and you will continue absolutely? So, what is that one thing you love about being on the ramp or anything you love that involves fashion and everything?
Yes. I am really, really passionate about walking on the ramp. Mm-hmm. I love wearing those gowns and, you know, showing them off on the ramp, and I love practicing my walk. At first, I used to have a very tough time walking in heels, and because I'm already this tall and this was the only heel I ever wore. And now I have to wear like 6 inches heels, yes, and I'm like 6'6", so I can't even enter my own house if I'm wearing those heels. So that's another thing. But then when you walk on the ramp, you have to be elegant, you have to think that you're a diva, and I really, really like doing that. So yes,
every girl in herself I think is a diva, but you have to figure it out yourself. So you know, you think that height is a very positive, it worked in a very positive way for you, because people think if you want to be in this fashion world, you got to have some good looks, a face. You already been gifted as a very, you have a very beautiful face, and height is a complimentary thing. So you think it worked in a very positive way for you?
Definitely. It was, I think, one of the most important aspects, because when I started working as a model, they wanted me to improve in many other areas, but they compromised with some things because of my height, because they couldn't find girls who are 6 feet tall, even in Mumbai. When I go there, I'm the tallest girl there. So that really helped, but it became as a drawback in some of the shows where, you know, the garments would just be very short for me and I couldn't go for that. But then, yeah, it mostly has worked for me in a very good way.
So ek baat mujhe jo personally puchni hai wo jab you know in the divas and pageants like this happens, they do the wave. I would love to see your wave. Have you learned that wave?
They told me to do that, and I'm very bad at it. I'm very bad at it. You know, I tried the Priyanka Chopra wave, but you know, I don't know. I started doing this, so I'm very bad at it. But I am practicing now that you've mentioned.
So we will get back to you for the wave thing.
Definitely.
So you mentioned about
the crown that time.
Okay, well, we're sure, and we wish you all the best for that. Ki aapki jaldi se jaldi crown aapke paas aaye. You mentioned Priyanka Chopra. So one diva that you follow and you get inspiration from that diva.
I think it would definitely be Priyanka Chopra, because she was the last person who won the Miss World crown, and I intend to be the next. And yes, so I think she is one of my inspirations. And yeah, she's grown in so many ways. Nobody could imagine that a girl who was just 17 years old and won Miss World, and then now she's one of the most celebrated celebrity in Hollywood.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's a very big thing. So I think she is an inspiration for many other girls.
So you are in college right now. So whenever you go to college, how is the atmosphere? The college students come up to you and say, hey, she's Miss Indore. How are you feeling? So what kind of vibes you get? And you know, when we say about success, abhi iti age mein success pana is like it's over the head. Agar aap chaho to zameen pe tik paate ho, nahi to it's like upar sar ke upar se nikal jaye. So how you take the whole thing?
Well, I take it very normally because I know that I have to stick to my roots. Or agar wo thoda sa bhi idhar se udhar hua, so people will misconceive that I have attitude or something like that, which I don't. I definitely don't. I greet them, they congratulate me, I thank them, and it's a very overwhelming feeling that people look up to you. And I never had that because in school I was an introvert and I never spoke to anybody. And now people tell me to address like more than 100 people. Like my father is a motivational speaker, so he also encourages me to talk to people and everything. So it's the transformation that mattered, and people appreciate that, and it really helps me.
एक्चुअली मैंने ये एक बात नोटिस करी, जितनी भी सक्सेसफुल लोग होते हैं दे ऑलवेज से कि भाई स्कूल में तो वी वर लाइक इंट्रोवर्ट पर्सन, वी यूजुअली डिडंट स्पीक मच एंड हम लोगों ने इंटरेक्ट नहीं किया, बट अब आगे जाके क्या क्या जलवे दिखा रहे हैं, वी कैन सी इट बाई आर सेल्स. ओके, सो आई टॉक्ड अबाउट द बेस्ट थिंग यू लव्ड अबाउट फैशन. द वर्स्ट थिंग, लाइक दे आस्क क्वेश्चंस, दे आस्क वेरी फ्रीक्वेंट क्वेश्चंस, व्हाई यू वॉन्ट टू बी इन दिस. सो एनी क्वेश्चन यू डिडंट लाइक और समथिंग यू डोंट लाइक अबाउट बींग इन this. I know it's a passionate thing, or you know, you wouldn't say any negative thing about it, but still there is something inside ki yaar theek hai yaar ye change ho jana chahiye, this is like thoda bahut change aa jaye to I would be comfortable and I would master all this thing. So that one thing would be,
well, I personally don't think that I have ever been through anything like that. I've been gifted with very good mentors who are very good to me, and I haven't faced that part of the industry yet. So, but yeah, the body shaming thing is a little, which I feel. But then it's necessary because they want, like, you know, when we had Barbie dolls, so we had this ideal figure that, you know, that she used to have. She has to have those idol eyes, she has to be a blonde. So that's what we had. So that's the conception it is. And I think now people are changing. Now in Lakme Fashion Week, they have curvy models as well. So I would definitely want to transform and be the best version of myself. But that's one thing that I feel is,
that should be changed. But okay, that's not a conception
that can
I can
actually. Uh-huh. Yeah, because that is something, that's the criteria, and every girl needs to fit in it. So now many girls, now they've shortened the height criteria to 5'5". So many girls don't fit that criteria. So I've been gifted with height, so there has to be something that I have to work on. Everything cannot come to me like a piece of cake. So yeah.
Okay. So in this industry, if we talk about media industry or fashion industry, so they say ki it's not for the girls because they do stuff and industries, they don't treat girls well. So you think that really these industries are not for the girls, or you know, they are all men-centric world around here?
Well, I think modeling industry is a woman-centric world, and girls, models are very bold enough and they can handle themselves, and that's why they are there. And I was initially very dependent on my father, but now I feel that, you know, if I have to live alone, I can, and if I have to face all those challenges alone, I can. And there is no such thing as a men-oriented world or something like that, because every girl now is independent and she's bold enough to pursue her dreams. And I really think that it doesn't matter if you're a woman or you're a man, but it's all about the passion that you have, and if you work towards it, you can achieve anything in life.
Wow. How simply and how beautifully she said it, like, yeah, you can achieve anything you want. It's like just a piece of cake, you can eat it, and it's just so simply, and that actually that reflects your confidence. And I would surely love to see your ramp walk because her height is very nice, so we'll see your ramp walk for sure right now. But at the end, I would love you to convey some message to the girls watching you out there who want to become a fashionista, a diva or something like that. So anything you want to say to them?
Well, hi girls, and thank you for watching. And the one thing that I would like to tell you is that just be very confident about yourself and follow your heart, because that thing will take you places. If you have a passion, follow it. Don't go around thinking about what the society thinks, because the society will always be there if you're confident enough, and you will pursue your dreams and you will achieve your goals. Because of that, I am here, and because of my parents' support, I am here. And you can always stand on your own feet and achieve your goals.
Wow.
All the best.
That was so sweet message. So do keep it in your mind, whatever she said. And all the best.
Thank you so much. Next time I take your interview,
it's the crown you are wearing of Miss India, Miss Universe, and the things I can not even imagine. So all the best with that, and thank you so much. Mannat Singh, and she talked beautifully, she walked confidently, and it was amazing talking to her. Kaisa laga hamara ye segment, zarur batayega, only on feedbackyuva@gmail.com. Till then, this is your Vijay Dhanvi signing off with camera person Mr. Manish Rao Jagaji. But you guys keep watching Hathway BTV Yuva, kyunki zamana hai we the youngsters ka. Bye bye.